Cameron, as it stands, voters will get a chance to vote for or against Gerald Hege, but that will take at least 3 days to find out whether or not those votes mean anything after the primary election. That's because the Board of Election will hold a hearing to decide whether or not Hege is even eligible to hold this position.
And I'm not worried about it. It's the least of my worries.
Gerald Hege, former Davidson County Sheriff turned convicted felon, now candidate for sheriff, speaks out about the Board of Elections' decision to hold a hearing about his qualifications for the position.
I made a mistake. The Constitution says you have to pay for it. I did that.
The 61-year-old candidate pled guilty to obstruction of justice while serving as sheriff. He resigned in 2003, then served 4 years probation. Now he wants his old job back.
He's not qualified for that office. He can run for mayor, county manager, whatever he wants, just not office of sheriff.
Melissa Proud and others filed a complaint with the Board of Elections. It claims Hege can't serve as sheriff because he can't carry a firearm. Now the Davidson County BOE says the allegations are serious enough to hold a hearing on.
I mean, I don't need to carry a weapon. I've been in a lot of places without weapons. You know, I'm a tough guy. You know, I have a reputation of being a tough guy.
It's not just specifically because his name's Gerald Hege, but because he's a convicted felon. You know, the law states that no convicted felon can be in possession, care, custody, or control of a firearm. It does not say unless elected sheriff.
But that hearing will take place on May 7th. That's 3 days after the primary, leaving many to question what's behind that move and the effects it could play on the general election.
If he makes it through the primary, then he still has this hearing to address before the November election, and that's the election that's really going to matter.
If you win this thing and they try to void that out, I wouldn't want to be in the county that week.
Why do you say that?
Well, you know, you'll have a lot of angry voters.